Hello, good afternoon. In tonight's video, I will be teaching you how to speak Spanish, and more specifically, I will be teaching you Colombian Spanish. For those who do not know me, I usually make ASMR videos in Spanish, and tonight I will be teaching you some common phrases and some common words. If you are new to a language learning journey, I have a couple recommendations for you. I am a native Spanish speaker, so I understand that this is easier for me, but I am a very big fan of learning new words in other languages, and I think the best method is to be consistent, to always have various methods of learning a language. So I'm glad that you're here listening to this video. I'm glad that you're mixing in your language learning with your relaxation time. I promise you, it will help a lot, a lot, a lot. I think the biggest recommendation that I have for you, if you really, really want to learn a new language, is to practice out loud. You can begin speaking privately, so you can talk while you're in bed. You can repeat the words that I teach you privately, whispering. You can repeat them in the shower, wherever you would like. And gradually, you build up the confidence to say them out loud. Hopefully, you build up the confidence to begin speaking a little bit of Spanish with your Spanish-speaking friends. That is the best way to learn a new language. You really have to get out of your comfort zone and practice it out loud. Okay, so we're gonna begin. I'm going to start off going over the usual hello, how are you type of speech, and then we'll move into a specific scenario. So I'm just going to introduce myself in Spanish. I will give you enough time to respond back if you would like. Hola, buenas tardes. Buenas tardes. ¿Cómo te va? Qué bien. Sí, yo me llamo Angélica. ¿Usted cómo se llama? Mucho gusto. Stop. This would be an example. ¿Vos cómo estás? ¿Cómo estás vos? Hola, buenas noches. ¿Cómo te está yendo? Qué bien. Yo me llamo Angélica. ¿Vos cómo te llamas? Mucho gusto. You are going to be going to a restaurant to try off Colombian food for the first time. You walk into a very farm-style looking restaurant in Medellin and you ask, Hola, buenas tardes. Una mesa. Una mesa para dos, por favor. And the waiter will sit you down, hand you the menu, and you're going to order a bandeja paisa. Bandeja paisa. That is a typical dish from Medellin, Colombia. And once they bring it to you, if you want to compliment the food, you're going to say, Estuvo riquísimo. Estuvo riquísimo. And you notice that rico means good. But you added ísimo to the end. Ísimo. Rico. That is very, very common. Spanish-speaking individuals love to exaggerate words. So we add ísimo, ísima to almost everything. So for example, estuvo riquísimo. It was delicious. It was extremely delicious. And continuing that line of thought, you can also add ito to almost everything. So let's say you want to ask for a little bit more rice. You're gonna say, ¿Me puedes dar un poquito más arroz? We add ito to everything. I think manzanita con un poquito de limoncito, pero ahorita. Manzanita, manzana, manzanita, limón, limoncito. Ahora, later, ahora, ahorita. So, you will sound like you know what you're saying if you had ito to a little bit more. So, me puedes dar un poquito más arroz, me puedes traer un poquito más de plátanos. And that's it. Okay. Now, moving on from that, let's say you finished your meal, you have to use the restroom. Perdón, ¿dónde están los baños? ¿Dónde? ¿Dónde están los baños? Where are the restrooms? Perdón, ¿a dónde están los baños? Going to continue with very commonly used words in Spanish. So I'm going to start off with ¿qué más? ¿Qué más? You can piece together ¿qué means what? Más means more. So ¿qué más? Would mean what more? What more? That's the literal meaning, but in Colombia we use que más as a greeting, essentially to say how's it going. So for example, oye, que más? ¿Cómo estás? You can layer it, so say hello, what's up? How are you? It's pretty much the same thing. So, oye, ¿qué más? You can say, ¿qué más pues? What's going on? What's up? It's very slang, but it's used very, very often. So, next time you see your Latino or Hispanic friend, you can say, hola, ¿qué más? Hola, ¿qué más? Remember that the literal meaning is what more, but it means what's up more, how's it going? Alright, next. This is just one simple word. Listo. Listo. Pretend you're saying list, but you can say listo, listo. The literal meaning of this is ready, ready. But in Colombia, we use listo to say okay, to say yes, and to say yeah. tries las manzanas, you're gonna say listo. Like, okay. Or yes, I will do it. You also say listo when you're actually ready. So, I'm going to ask you, are you ready? ¿Estás listo? ¿Estás listo? It's definitely a little bit cooler to keep it in the short form. So you're gonna say parce. ¿Qué más, parce? ¿Cómo estás? Mi parcero. Parcero. This is a very popular word in reggaeton songs. We do have different words. So, in Colombia, for example, to say that something is very cool, we're gonna use the word bacano. Bacano. Another word that is pretty popular, not as popular as bacano, is chévere. 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 And let's use these words sentences so that you understand them better. So, parce, esa canción estuvo súper bacana. canción estuvo súper chévere. Esa canción estuvo súper bacana. Parce, esa canción estuvo súper chévere. So, the next couple of words kind of go hand in hand. I think by the end we can definitely use them in a phrase. So, let me start this off by asking. So this means, hey bro, would you like to go partying with me? The word that Colombians like to use for partying is rumbear. La palabra rumbear viene de la palabra rumba. De una, which literally means from one, but to Colombians, de una means yes, let's do it right now. You can use de una for anything that you're excited about. So if I ask you to go apple picking with me, you can say de una. Of course, let's do it. It's a way to show your excitement. It's very, very popular in my culture. Alright. The next word we have is also very, very specific. Not to be confused with parce. Parce literally means spot or patch, but we use it to mean the spot where we hang out, like the cool spot or the fun spot. So you're gonna use parce if your friend calls you and you're out partying with me. You're going to say, sí, parce, estamos en el parche. It sounds a little bit corny, but it's used very often, and you're practically saying, yes, bro, we're at the spot right now. Entonces, parche. Means the spot or the place word. Nosotros salimos a rumbear. Y estábamos en el parche. Y en la mañana te despertaste con un guayabo. Tengo un guayabo terrible. Bro, I have a terrible hangover. Alright. Okay. Last two words. I think after this, you're gonna be the coolest Colombian speaking person. And you'll probably understand Narcos a little bit more now. But anyway, another word that we use often is Lucas. Lucas is a name. It is Lucas. But we don't mean it to refer to an actual person. We use Lucas to refer to money. So, yo no tengo dinero. Yo no tengo plata. Yo no tengo Lucas. Lucas is very slang, but it means the same thing. Yo no tengo dinero. Yo no tengo plata. Yo no tengo Lucas. Entonces, por ejemplo, parce, yo no tengo lucas para ir a rumbear. My little lesson in Colombia. I hope you practice these words a little bit. I always think that learning slang in a language is extremely important. In school, you're going to